Assalamualaikum and very good morning to my dear students. Welcome to my Arabic class. I am Sumaiya. And we are doing here recapitulation of class 5's Arabic lessons. Right? So my dear students, in previous video, we did lesson number 14, part 1, Fil Mustashfa, which is our topic, Fil Mustashfa, in the hospital. And I told you that time also that in this lesson there is two part of this lesson, that part A, part B, Alif and Ba. So part A's topic we covered in previous video. Now we will go, doing here recapitulation of part B, means Ba. Understood? So what is our topic is Indat Tabibi, right? With the doctor. In first video, in first part, part A, we see or we learn how to talk with the doctor and what doctor asks to the patient, that kind of some statement in part A. Now in part B, there is some new disease name also, what you call it in Arabic, right? So you learn something more about hospitality. So see on the board, Ba Indat Tabibi means part B, and our topic name is with the doctor. As you can see in the picture, there is one patient sitting here, one doctor sitting here, and they are doing a conversation about health, right? So Al Marizu, the patient says, Masa Al Khair, good evening. Al Tabibu, the doctor says, Masa Al Nur, good evening. As you know, in Islam, we say someone, whenever we meet to someone, we call Assalamu Alaikum, then they are answering us, Wa Alaikum Assalam. Understood? What is the meaning of it? Peace be upon you. Right? And answer one, peace be upon you too. So, same it is, someone is say good morning or good evening. Here is good evening. Good morning, Hoto, Sabah Al Khair or Sabah Al Noor. So whenever you say someone good morning, so they are also answering you good morning. Here, Masa Al Khair means good evening. Our patient says good evening, the doctor also greeting him, Masa Al Noor, good evening. Al Marizu, the patient says, Mumkin Al Khulu, right? That's meaning is, may I come in? Or may I enter in your cabin? At Tabibu, doctor says, Tafazzal. You can say yes, of course, or something like that. Ma indaka, what do you have? This is the bodily meaning, what do you have? Or maza asabaka, they are giving us in a bracket, means what happened to you. Ma indaka means what do you have? And in a bracket they are giving us maza asabaka means what happened to you. Both have this zamire, muttasila wahid muzakkar hazir, means singular male, second person, zamir muttasila means attached pronouns. Al-Marizu, the patient says, Alamul Batni. In previous video also I say you that Alamul means pain. You can attach here any another word, so it's make a body pain. In first lesson you learn Alamul Jismi. Now Alamul Batni means stomach ache, pet ka dard. Okay? Al-Tabibu, the doctor says, Hal Inda Ka Ishal, do you have a diarrhea? Means if you have a stomach ache, so do you have a diarrhea? Al-Marizu, the patient says, Suvi Kalilan, yeah, little bit. At-Tabibu, the doctor says, Mata Bada'a. Mata is a question word, as you know. Bada'a, start. So Mata Bada'a, when it started. Al-Marizu, the patient says, Sabah. Sabaha means morning, early because of food poisoning. Mumkin means possible. Hasa, this in tasammumi taam because of food poisoning. A taam means food, tasammum means poison. So, Anveshan says, I take today the chapati and the beans. Possible, this is because of food poisoning. A tabibu, the doctor said,
Almarizu,
the patient says, So now we will do exercises of part B of lesson number 14. So see on the board, chapter 14, right? Part B. Revision. And now what we are doing? Exercises, right? So first exercise is, see in your book page number 73, and read page number 73. Ajit means answer the following. On what we call it in Arabic? Ajit. Right? So now we write down here only answer. First question is, Uskur Bazar Asmaul Amraz Ashshayar. Means you have to say some disease name what you see in this lesson. So first of all, in part A we learn Kalma means fever, then Alamul Jismi. And to have this book or take care, you have to take care. Lakhda also you attach here, okay? And to have this book, Ala Nazafatil Bayt, wa asas wal Pimpati Wal Malagis Wal Makula. excited. I hope you all have understood these three question and answer. Now you do exercise number 2. Write the plural. See, lots of plural are made in previous lesson also. So I write down only answer here. So exercise number 2 is write the plural. First the word is the worrisome, so its answer is alamra. Second one is tabibun, so atibbaun. Tabibun means doctor, atibbaun means doctors. Tahanun means food, so its plural is atimatun. Then alamun means pain, so its plural is alam. Then yawmun means day, so its plural is ayyam, days, right? Then maun, baikun, dawaun. See, maun means its plural is miyahun. Baikun's plural is buyutun, house. And dawaun means medicine. Its plural is adbiyatun. So I hope you all are understood this singular plural. For exercise is using sentence, what we don't have to do now. Now we will do our fourth exercise, which is translate into English. They are giving us some statement in Arabic. We have to translate in English. So here we have to translate some English statement into Arabic. First statement is, can I enter? 1.